Peace world, I hope all is well. I'm little disturbed by post I read that KIK knowledge is king. The name of the post is In the Mind of a White Supremacist? A speech by Pieter Willembota, 1985. Listen. Pieter Willembota's time on this earth was from the 12th of January 1916 to the 31st of October 2006, commonly known as PW and Diegroot Crocodile, Afrikaans for the Big Crocodile. Was the Prime Minister of South Africa from 1978 to 1984 and the first Executive State President from 1984 to 1989. First elected to Parliament in 1948, Botha was for 11 years head of the Afrikaner National Party and the South African government. Although a fierce opponent to black majority rule and communism, his government did make concessions towards political reform, whereas internal unrest saw widespread human rights abuses on the hands of the government as well as the militant opposition. Botha resigned the party leadership in February 1989 after suffering a stroke and 6 months later was coerced to leave the presidency as well. In F.W. de Klerk's 1992 referendum, Botha campaigned for a no vote and denounced de Klerk's administration as irresponsible. In early 1998, when Botha refused to testify at the Mandela government's Truth and Reconciliation Commission, he was supported by the right-wing Conservative Party, which had earlier contested his rule, in his refusal and was fined and given a suspended jail sentence later that year. Shortly before his death in late 2006, he renewed his opposition towards egalitarian democracy in favor of a confederate system based upon the principles of separate development. Botha was not related to contemporary National Party politician Roelof Frederik Pike Botha, his Minister of Foreign Affairs. First, the backdrop for the speech. The following is a speech made by former South African President P.W. Botha to his cabinet. This reprint was written by David G. Maloo for the Sunday Times, a South African newspaper, dated August 18, 1985. Now for the speech. Pretoria has been made by the white mind for the white man. We are not obliged even the least to try to prove to anybody and to the blacks that we are superior people. We have demonstrated that to the blacks in 1001 ways. The Republic of South Africa that we know of today has not been created by wishful thinking. We have created it at the expense of intelligence, sweat and blood. Were they Afrikaners who tried to eliminate the Australian Aborigines? Are they Afrikaners who discriminate against blacks and call them niggers in states? Were they Afrikaners who started the slave trade? Where is the black man appreciated? England discriminates against its black and their sus law is out to discipline the blacks. Canada, France, Russia, and Japan all play their discrimination too. Why in the hell then is so much noise made about us? Why are they biased against us? I'm simply trying to prove to you all that there is nothing unusual we are doing that the so-called civilized worlds are not doing. We are simply an honest people who have come out aloud with a clear philosophy of how we want to live our own white life. We do not pretend like other whites that we like blacks. The fact that blacks look like human beings and act like human beings do not necessarily make them sensible human beings. Hedgehogs are not porcupines and lizards are not crocodiles simply because they look alike. If God wanted us to be equal to the blacks, he would have created us all of a uniform color and intellect. But he created us differently, whites, blacks, yellow, rulers and the ruled. Intellectually, we are superior to the blacks. That has been proven beyond any reasonable doubt over years. I believe that the Afrikaner is an honest, God-fearing person, who has demonstrated practically the right way of being. Nevertheless, it is comforting to know that behind the scenes, Europe, America, Canada, Australia and all others are behind us in spite of what they say. For diplomatic relations, we all know what languages would be used and where. To prove my point, comrades, does any one of you know a white country without an investment or interest in South Africa? Who buys our gold? Who buys our diamonds? Who trades with us? Who is helping us develop other nuclear weapon? The very truth is that we are their people and they are our people. It's a big secret. The strength of our economy is backed by America, Britain and Germany. It is our strong conviction, therefore, that the black is the raw material for the white man, so brothers and sisters, let us join hands together to fight against this black devil. I appeal to all Afrikaners to come out with any creative means of fighting this war. Surely God cannot forsake his own people whom we are. By now every one of us has seen it practically that the blacks cannot rule themselves. Give them guns and they will kill each other. They are good in nothing else but making noise, dancing, marrying many wives and indulging in sex. Let us all accept that the black man is the symbol of poverty, mental inferiority, laziness and emotional incompetence. Isn't it plausible? Therefore, that the white man is created to rule the black man? Come to think of what would happen one day if you woke up and on the throne sat a Kaffir. Can you imagine what would happen to our women? Does any one of you believe that the blacks can rule this country? Hence, we have good reasons to let them all the Mandela's rot in prison, and I think we should be commended for having kept them alive in spite of what we have at hand with which to finish them off. I wish to announce a number of new strategies that should be put to use to destroy this black bug. We should now make use of the chemical weapon. Priority number 1, we should not by all means allow any more increases of the black population lest we be choked very soon. I have exciting news that our scientists shave come with an efficient stuff. I'm sending out more researchers to the field to identify as many venues as possible where the chemical weapons could be employed to combat any further population increases. The hospital is a very strategic opening, for example, and should be fully utilized. The food supply channel should be used. We have enveloped excellent slow-killing poisons and fertility destroyers. Our only fear is in case such stuff came into their hands as they are bound to start using it against us if you care to think of the many blacks working for us in our homes. However, we are doing the best we can to make sure that the stuff remains strictly in our hands. Secondly, most blacks are vulnerable to money and usements. I have set aside a special fund to exploit this venue. The old trick of divide and rule is still very valid today. Our experts should work day and night to set the black man against his fellow man. His inferior sense of morals can be exploited beautifully. And here is a creature that lacks foresight. There is a need for us to combat him in long-term projections that he cannot suspect. The average black does not plan his life beyond a year, that stands, for example, should be exploited. My special department is already working round the clock to come out with a long-term operation blueprint. I am also sending a special request to all Afrikaner mothers to double their birth rate. It may be necessary to set up a population boom industry by putting up centers where we employ and support fully white young men and women to produce children for the nation. We are also investigating the merit of uterus rentals as a possible means of speeding up the growth of our population through surrogate mothers. For the time being, we should also engage a higher gear to make sure that black men are separated from their women and fines imposed upon married wives who bear illegitimate children. I have a committee working on finding better methods of inciting blacks against each other and encouraging murders among themselves. Murder cases among blacks should bear very little punishment in order to encourage them. My scientists have come up with a drug that could be smuggled into their brews to effect slow poisoning results and fertility destruction. Working through drinks and manufacturing of soft drinks geared to the blacks could promote the channels of reducing their population. Ours is not a war that we can use the atomic bomb to destroy the blacks, so we must use our intelligence to effect this. The person-to-person encounter can be very effective, as the records show that the black man is dying to get to bed with the white woman. Here is our unique opportunity. Our sex mercenary squad should go out and camouflage with apartheid fighters, while doing their operations quietly administering slow-killing poison and fertility destroyers to those blacks they thus befriend. We are modifying the sex mercenary squad by introducing white men who should go for the militant black woman and any other vulnerable black woman. We have received a new supply of prostitutes from Europe and America who are desperate and too keen to take up the appointments. My latest appeal is that the maternity hospital operations should be intensified. We are not paying those people to help bring black babies to this world but to eliminate them on the very delivery moment. If his department worked very efficiently, a great deal could be achieved. My government has set aside a special fund for erecting more covert hospitals and clinics to promote this program. Money can do anything for you. So while we have it, we should make the best use of it. In the meantime, my beloved white citizens, do not take to heart what the world says, and don't be ashamed of being called racists. I do not mind being called the architect and king of apartheid. I shall not become a monkey simply because someone has called me a monkey. I will still remain your bright star. His Excellency, Botha. That's the end of the speech, wow. Don't be so naive to think this mindset is not alive in 2012.